Sony announces the Xperia Z Ultra phablet to the masses. The company also announced their waterproof smartwatch 2, and a Samsung Galaxy S4 with a Snapdragon 800 processor gets leaked. I'm Jaime Rivera, and yeah, there's only 4 days left for the weekend. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let's start today off with some news that'll make some of you happy and some of you very mad. And the reason why is because we knew that there was going to be an LTE Advanced variant of the Galaxy S4 in the works, but there are some leaked photographs of the phone already, and guess what? It's also rocking the Snapdragon 800 processor at times when we know that the processor is superior to the Snapdragon 600 or the octa-core Exynos processor you guys are rocking right now. So doesn't it burn to be an early adopter? Now let's move on over to some other probably upsetting news, as Reuters is now reporting that Microsoft is in very advanced stages of bringing Xbox games to iOS and Android. Apparently the first game to reach both platforms is Age of Empires, and apparently you will be getting it for free as part of the bundle, aside from other goodies that Microsoft is probably intending for both platforms. So for those of you that are rocking a Windows phone right now, yeah, you can use the comments. You can tell Microsoft what you think. Now, we're just a couple of days away from Nokia's July 11th event, and according to a very reliable tipster, we will be getting a smartphone at this event, and apparently it will be the new PureView EOS. Apparently that's going to be the name of the new smartphone that'll bring the 41 megapixel camera to a Windows Phone device. Do you really believe that this 41 megapixel camera is really going to make Windows Phone take off? Leave us a comment down below and let's see what we get at this July 11th event. We will be covering it live. Now, Sony's event just happened in Asia and we got a lot of products, but one of the most compelling ones is that we did get the smartwatch 2. Yes, we did get a smartwatch, and it's the smartwatch 2, which blends the design of the Xperia Z. It's got the power button, it's got the waterproof and dustproof specifications. It works with NFC, it has Bluetooth 3.0 to connect with your Xperia smartphone, or I hopefully believe that any other smartphone as well. And well, it does bring a lot of compelling features to provide Android support to a watch. The question is if you're really interested in this product. So again, leave us a comment if you're interested. I love the design. I love the fact that it's finally waterproof. I would buy it, but then again, we will be having to wait until probably September when it gets launched. And finally, for the hot news of the day, Sony has also unveiled their first phablet. It's called the Sony Xperia Z Ultra. As if they just ran out of names, this thing is humongous. It's a 6.3-inch display, and it's got all the bells and whistles. Sony finally brings a cutting-edge processor to their next phone. It's the Snapdragon 800, and therefore the phone won't be available until Q3 2013. It's got 1080p display. It's got a triluminous display that brings more enhanced colors to the display, which I hope so, because the display on the Xperia Z and ZL was really bad. But anyways, links in the description for full specs and details on the phone. And that leads me to the question of the day. You know, out of the videos and everything that you'll see in the description, what do you think about this phone? Would you like an Xperia Z Ultra? In my particular case, I am a fan of phablets. I do like them, and I do like the fact that it's waterproof as well. I just don't know what I'd do with a phone that big. So leave us a comment down below. Would you be interested? Of course, as always, for an earlier scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter at Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you tomorrow.